All right, over the weekend, a number of people reached out to me and asked a phenomenal question. And I love the question that they asked because it opens up a huge opportunity that absolutely no one is talking about right now. All right, what's the question that I was asked? Well, effectively, people are wanting to know, does Dataverse MCP Server eliminate the need for PowerFX functions as we've known them? Now, what I love about this question is it opens up the opportunity to talk about something super important that none of us are talking about right now, which is how do we create an end-to-end low-code natural language experience for agentic AI that lets us realize faster time to value. All right. Now, as a quick refresher, PowerFX functions, the artist formerly known as low-code plugins, were announced a couple of years ago at the Build conference, and they've been in preview ever since. And they're pretty special because for the first time, we could author synchronous business logic in a low-code way. We didn't need to write C#. We simply used PowerFX, which compiled down to C# behind the scenes. Now, they're triggered manually, either by a user interacting with an application or by a Dataverse unbound action. And you can use any Power Platform connection, including your custom connectors with them. So basically, these are now limitlessly extensible. And to get a little geeky, instead of web API, they use the iOrganization service, which means they don't consume as many web API calls. So it lets you be a little bit more efficient with your web API calls. All right. Now, you're probably saying, Nathan, you've been oddly silent on the topic of PowerFX. We love the Copilot Studio content you've been doing, but we haven't really heard anything PowerFX-y from you in quite some time. So let's put them together. Let's see what we might be able to do. Which brings us to this big idea. All right. PowerFX functions make Dataverse MCP Server endlessly extensible in a low-code way. Let me repeat that. PowerFX functions make Dataverse MCP Server endlessly extensible in a low-code way. Why? Well, what they let us do is create a library of reusable deterministic functions that an agent using Dataverse MCP Server can call when it needs to. Now, if you've worked with Copilot Studio before, you know that generally speaking, tools are agent-specific. Now, that's starting to change a bit with agent flows, but by and large, a tool has been bound to an agent. This means that we can't do good solution architecture 101, which is create a reusable library of stuff that we need to do all the time. For example, let's say we need to calculate the number of working days. This comes up in every single project ever. It doesn't matter whether you are doing dynamic CE or ERP. It doesn't matter whether it's Power Apps or Power Automate or Copilot Studio. There is always a requirement to calculate how many non-weekend, non-public holidays are between date X and date Y. And so this is a perfect example of creating something reusable that we can consume across the Power Platform. All right, so if we wanted to do this, this is how the components that we'd use to start putting this together. So firstly, in Copilot Studio, we've got our agent instructions and all of the orchestration. Next, we connect to Dataverse MCP because this is what does stuff for us. Now, what's really cool about MCP, beside the fact that it is incredibly easy to use and hook up to with an agent, is that Dataverse MCP has a whole list of things that it can do. It can look up stuff, it can create stuff, it can update stuff. And that's just a small subset of the things that it can do. Now, when it is called by the agent passes it a prompt. It's going to pass it, here's my instructions, here's what I'm being asked to do. And MCP is going to say, cool, here's what you're asking me to do, here's what I know how to do, and then it's going to determine how to run that, right? Which of my functions do I need to run in which order to accomplish what I'm being asked to do? It's really cool, and all you have to do is connect to it, and it does all that for you. All right, And then finally, we've got our PowerFX function. And so this is where we can create deterministic business logic and extend the Power Platform as we need to. So Dataverse MCP lets us do our CRUDs, but sometimes we need something more specialized, more specific to our process or to our business. And we can use tools like PowerFX functions to author that business logic and then call it as need be. Okay, let's get into a specific example of this, how I envision this working. All right, so we've got an autonomous agent, and our autonomous agent is going to receive WhatsApp replies from customers. So we send WhatsApp messages to our customers, and they reply back to us. Now, when the agent gets a reply, it needs to identify the customer. It then, based on that customer, needs to work out their most recent issue. Let's just assume for a minute that we've got a Dataverse table called issue. And then based on the number of working days between when that issue was created in Dataverse and right now when we got that WhatsApp message, it needs to determine what it's supposed to do. Let's say if there are 10 working days or less, we go down pathway number one. And if it's more than 10 working days, we go down pathway number two. All right, so that's what the agent's going to do. Dataverse MCP makes it really easy for us to look up the customer. Again, we're getting a WhatsApp message. So based on that number, we can quickly figure out who the customer is. Now that we know who the customer is, Dataverse MCP makes it really easy to find the issues related to that customer and the open ones. But now we need to calculate the working days between our two dates. And so how do we handle this? We could build this in the agent, but again, this comes up all the time in almost every project ever. So it'd be really great if we just had something reusable that we could create and then call it across the Power Platform as need be. So we can do that if we've got a reusable function. We just need to have MCP server pass the parameters into it coming from the customer and the issue that it's looked up and the current date and time, and then our function can do the rest. And so this is where PowerFX functions starts to enter the game. And so our function can quickly and easily work out those working days. Now we also need a location, and it's going to call an API. And so based on the location and the dates, it can come back to us with a number of working days. It can do that really easily. And then once it's done that, we just go back to the agent, and the agent can continue on with its task based on the number of working days. So this is how we can combine these elements of the autonomous agent, Dataverse MCP, and then extend it in a low-code way with PowerFX functions to have it run specific logic that we need it to do. All right, why is this such a big deal? Well, firstly, this reduces the need to configure agent-specific tools. So traditionally, we've had, if you've worked in Copilot Studio, you know that the tools have been agent-bound. Now, again, that is changing with things like agent flows, but we don't have to create a bunch of tools for the agent. We simply have to create our agent, add instructions to it, and connect to Dataverse MCP, and we're away. It's going to handle the rest for us. Natural language becomes our development tool of choice. We simply have to write agent instructions, and hooked up to MCP, it handles the rest for us. This is an end-to-end low-code solution, and we get faster time to value. Again, because all we have to do is write natural language, write really clear instructions for that agent, we don't have to spend a lot of time configuring tools. And so we can realize value from our agents using MCP much, much faster. All right, well, how do we get there? So as of right now today, what I have just taken you through isn't super possible with the out-of-the-box preview tools. So what I would love to see is a perform an unbound action tool added to the Dataverse MCP capabilities. Because behind the scenes, PowerFX functions are just unbound actions. That's all they are. And so if we add that, this opens up a massive option set of things that MCP server can start to do in ways that we can extend it without writing code. Now, you could probably do this today if you created a custom Dataverse MCP server. Otherwise, we've got to wait for the product team to add this tool in. Hopefully, this is on the radar. And as a side note, this all does hinge on a GA date for PowerFX functions. So they've been in preview for a couple of years. We've all been kind of struggling to work out where exactly do these fit in a world of agentic AI. Hopefully this example that I'm just taking you through starts to illustrate how powerful these PowerFX functions are and how they make Dataverse MCP Server that much more powerful and extensible. All right, let's go through a couple of questions before we wrap things up. Firstly, why PowerFX functions? Couldn't we just vibe code all of this? And you know what? You're right. We could vibe code all of this in GitHub Copilot. We could assemble some C# code and have it do all of this for us. What PowerFX functions do so elegantly is they handle everything from our connection. So if you need to connect to an API, like in our example, we don't have to worry about those connection strings. That's all handled with our Power Platform connectors. We don't have to worry about creating and registering plugin steps. That's all done for us. We don't have to worry about source control. Again, that's all handled for us. We just have to author the PowerFX, add in our connectors, and we're away. So it's a much simpler, much cleaner, much more elegant, and of course, low-code solution. Next, why don't we just use Power Automate? Well, again, for async processing, Power Automate is going to be just fine. As it stands today, right now today, end of July 2025, if you were to use Dataverse MCP and Power Automate together, you'd have a bit of complexity in configuring your agent because you'd need to add Dataverse MCP as a tool. You would then need to add the agent flows you wanted as tools, and you'd have to handle the interchanges between both of them in terms of data coming in and going out, as well as ensuring that your agent's instructions let it know when it's to use the agent flow, when it's to use the MCP server, and so you've got a bit of complexity there. The solution that I've just taken you all through eliminates all of that. All you have to do is create an agent, add instructions, connect to Dataverse MCP, and the rest is taken care of for you. And so that's why I believe that PowerFX functions create some really elegant ways to quickly realize value with Dataverse MCP in Copilot Studio and agentic AI scenarios. What do you all think? Drop a comment, let me know. In the meantime, go do something awesome on the Power Platform today, and I'll talk to you all soon.